Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. Today, we're at corporate headquarters for ZEISS in Oberkochen. Nestled on the far end of campus is our ZEISS CMM production area. And today, what we're going to do is look at one of the crown jewels of our CMM portfolio, the Xenos. I came from the mud, there's dirt on my hands. So the Xenos is one of the most accurate CMMs in the world. And what we will do today, of course, is have a look at one. So come on in, let's see what it's all about. Try to catch me howling at the moon. Okay, so what is a micron? Well, before we start, let's bring in Alessandro, who is the product manager for the Xenos.
Yeah, hello, Jay.
Hi, Alessandro, how are you?
Nice to see you. Fine, okay. Thanks.
Great. We were just talking about what a micron is. A micron, okay, your human hair is 100 microns. So, 1 micron is 1/100th of a human hair. So, how accurate is this machine?
Oh, this is the most accurate machine that we have in our product portfolio. This is 0.3 plus L over 1,000.
0.3, so that is 1/3 of a micron, but what's L over 1,000?
Yeah, imagine if you want to measure 1 meter, then the accuracy to measure this meter is 1.3 micrometer, because you have to sum 0.3 plus the meter, 1,000 millimeter, this is the meaning of the formula, just to have the accuracy, how to accurate is the machine to measure this meter.
Okay, so L is in meters, and however many meters there are, you add that to 0.3.
Three. Exactly.
Got it.
Very good, Jay.
Got it. That's very accurate. How do we do this?
This is was a very high level project that we did here by ZEISS. We develop also new material, we develop a new construction. We take over the experience that we have, 25 years old experience that we have on this project, to have the most accurate machine, or one of the most accurate machine of the world. For example, we have also new materials like silicon carbide. This is the first time that such material is used by the CMM. Just to imagine, silicon carbide is 4 times stiffer than other material like granite, for example, that also used by the competitor. And this material is just to give the most stiffness of the structure. It is used, for example, for the X-axis, for the Z-axis, and for all movable parts of the CMM. And you can also see here the color of the material. This is this gray color. And also to achieve this high accuracy, we have and we develop a new drive technology. It's what we call virtual central drive, because we have two engines on the left and the right sides to compensate the bending error and to compensate what we call the Abbe error. The Abbe error is just is the adjustment that you have, or the offset that you have between the glass scale and the other sides and the measurements. If you have some bending error, that's what we call Abbe error. In this case, if you have two engines on the left and the right and two glass scale on the left on the right sides, then you have the possibility to avoid this error, because you have every time the information about the position of the probe inside your measurement volume. Let's say for a standard CMM in our product portfolio, like Prismo, like Acura, like Contura, every time the structure of the machine is to have one glass scale on one side and engine linear drives on the one side. It means if you have a fast acceleration, you don't know what's happened on the other sides. In this case, with this new concept, we know exactly where the bridge is and where, and we can compensate every every arrow, we know very well where
the... So there are two drives on this one.
Yes, that's right. And we have also two glass case for the first time with 1 nanometer resolution.
Wow.
This is the first time that the CMM in our product portfolio has such glass scale. And let me say, it's all full package to allow us to achieve that accuracy.
That's great. That's great. And it looks cool.
How many of these are there in the world?
Right now, we have 12 installations worldwide. Over the world, it means. And let me say, there are different customer. It could be, for example, National Institute. It could be some companies. There were some companies that told me, yeah, we decide to buy the Xenos just to avoid all the discussion that we have inside the company. If we have to a measurement result, nobody knows if it's okay or not the results, and there is a lot of discussion. And with this machine, they say if we have such problems, so we measure the part on this machine, then they stop off the discussion, everybody accept it, and they start to work again.
Perfect.
Then, okay, let me say a lot of companies, industry, as a reference machine, institute, or calibration laboratory.
Sure.
And let me mention, for example, also NIST, this is the National Institute in US, they have also...
Wow.
Xenos, they
wow.
use for a project, for the Big G project, to evaluate the gravity, acceleration gravity.
They're using one of these for that?
They use one of these wow. of that, exactly.
Well, Alessandro, thanks for showing us the machine, talking to us about it.
Was a pleasure.
Thank you, appreciate
Thank you.
It. We'll see you soon.
See you next time.
Yep,
yeah?
Yep,
ciao,
cheers,
ciao.
Bye. Okay, everyone, that was the Xenos. Thanks for joining us at the Measuring Hero blog. Don't forget to join us every Thursday where we'll do something cool like this. And for now, bye.